Been a lot of talk about Austin developing a sobriety center, also known to some people as a drunk tank. It would be an alternative to jail for people who have too much to drink so they could sober up. Well, today Austin City Council will decide if the city manager should develop a plan and funding strategy to start one. KXAN's Sophia Beausoleil is live for us from City Hall. Good morning.
Good morning, Sally. So last week, Travis County commissioners gave the okay for them to work with Austin officials to develop a sobriety center. And just like you said, this is seen as an alternative rather than sending people to jail or to the hospitals. Now, Houston and San Antonio have these sobriety centers, also known as drunk tanks, and they're seen as places that offer support and encourage treatment for alcoholism. Now, the Austin-Travis County EMS Association said earlier this month that sobriety centers would free up police officers' time rather than them spending it on public intoxication. Now, earlier this week, we spoke with Austin Police Chief R. Acevedo after the Chiefs run. We asked him what he thinks about the idea of a sobriety center, and he says it has its pros and cons, and he has his concerns.
Do I think it's worthy of exploration? Absolutely. But there are a lot of questions that need to be answered, including who pays for it and including under what circumstances would people specifically be placed in that detox center. Listen, one of the drunkest cities in the country. I don't want to create something where people think, hey, come to Austin, get as drunk as you want, and you don't have to worry about it. There's no consequences. We'll just stick you in a place to sober up and that's it. That's an invitation to chaos as far as I'm concerned.
Now, coming up on KXAN News at 7 o'clock on the CW Austin, which is KNVA on your TV guide, we're going to be talking to the medical director for Brackenridge Emergency Department. We're going to hear what he has to say from his perspective and the fact that they see people who are intoxicated come through the ERs. Also, just what he thinks about having a sobriety center here in town. Reporting live from City Hall in downtown Austin, Sophia Beausoleil, KXAN News.
Yes, somebody has to pay for it either way, Sophia, either at the hospital or with the sobriety center. Thank you for that. We'll see you over on the CW Austin. Public intoxication arrests, by the way, take a lot of time away from law enforcement, as you heard the chief say. Here's more perspective on the number of cases Travis County is managing. Last year, 3,700 people were arrested for public intoxication. In that same year, University of Texas police arrested 169 people.